Hi friends, in the last videos we covered declarations and access modifiers. What is a Java source file structure, import statement, package statement, class level modifiers, member modifiers, interfaces. Beautiful concepts are even almost around some possible bits also I discussed for the exam. Sir, now the next important concept, very important for the interview room, even for our certification exam, what that concept is, OOPS concept, right? Are you getting? Sir, OOPS object oriented programming, OOPS features, we require to discuss. Beautiful concept, very heart for CoreJava is this concept. That's why take a bit more special care. But unfortunately, sir, I may not discuss each and everything which is present inside OOPS because all the things for our certification is not required. Up to certification, sir, for certification level, whatever things are required, up to that I will discuss. Sir, the people who are very much interested to know each and everything, download our material, just go through that. Sir, the first, I have to discuss, sir, data hiding. Are you getting? What is the first topic we have to discuss? Data hiding, right? Sir, can you please tell what is data hiding? The first OOP feature, sir, data hiding. The name itself indicates, have you observed, right? Hiding of data. So our internal data should not go out directly. Regarding, so whatever internal data is there, which is should not go out directly, that means outside person should not access our internal data directly. We have to hide our data. Okay, like, sir, can you give an example so that we may get much clarity? Best example, sir, you have to check your mail, Gmail, you have to check is there any new mails came or not. To check your mail, sir, just www.gmail.com, immediately your inbox page is not going to come. Regarding it won't come. Compulsory, you have to provide your mail ID and password. Then only Gmail people are going to provide, so your mail's information. So here your mail data is not coming directly. So some sort of validation must be required. Hey, please provide your username and password. Then only I can able to tell your mail information. Are you getting right? So some sort of validation, after validation, then only the data is going to come. So if any person is allowed to access any person mail ID, meaningless. Are you getting any person mail data, meaningless. Are you getting? So I have my own secrets are there. If some third party person can able to access my mail, he can able to see my mails, where is the security? Are you getting right? That's why our internal data should not go out directly. Outside person should not access. Compulsory, some sort of validation must be required. Yes, if this person is the valid, after validation, then only I can able to provide. You are getting? Suppose assume that I have ICICI bank account is there, sir. Then I will go to the bank. Hey, can you please tell how much account balance I have? Like, bank people, simply they are going to ask, what is your account number? Is there any ID proof? Are you getting? Is there any ID proof like, yes, myself, my ID proof is like this. Then the bank people are going to check, okay, your account balance is so and so, like this, right? Or if you want to check your ICICI bank account balance, so online, then automatically, so immediately ICICIbank.com, can you please tell my account balance? No, first you have to provide your user ID, password, and then sometimes OTP also must be required to provide. Then only it is going to tell your account balance is like. Sir, are you getting? So our mail data, are you getting? Our mail data, sir, should not go out directly. First, if any person is asking, hey, can you please provide mail data? First, provide your username and password. Sir, my account balance information is not going directly. First, if any person is asking, can you please provide my account data? First, you have to tell your username and password, then only I can able to provide your account information. So our internal data should not go out directly. Some sort of other authentication must be required, then only the data should go. This type of beautiful WUPO feature is nothing but what? Data hiding. Everyone can able to understand, right? Sir, theoretically, okay, sir, data hiding, hiding of the data. So, any person is not allowed to access any data, some sort of authentication must be required, like this, right? Sir, programmatically, how you can implement a data hiding? Very, very simple, sir. Assume that I have class account is there. Assume that, sir. Class account is there. Every account having balance. Every account having balance. Balance, sir. Public double balance. Balance is there. Okay, like. Sir, you know, private double balance. Okay. So, by declaring this balance variable as the private, by declaring this balance variable as the private, we can implement data hiding. Are you able to understand, right? So, how you can implement data hiding, sir? By declaring, sir, data member as the private, we can make outside person unable to access this data. Sir, this variable can be used just for internal purpose only, like this, right? Then immediately you ask, sir, I want to check my account balance. How I can access this variable, sir? Directly, you can't access this balance. Then, if you want to know your balance information, okay, I will call get a balance method. I will call get a balance method. Okay, can you please give get balance? Get balance is the public. Any person can able to call get balance method. In that get balance method, yes, whatever validation you want to perform, sir, perform validation. Hey, provide username and password. If a username and password are valid, sir, if valid, provide balance. If valid, okay, return balance. If not valid, then automatically, sorry, you are not allowed to access this information. Like that, I can able to write the code. Are you able to understand? So, outside person should not access our data directly. Okay? Compulsory, he has to call a method. Within that method, we have to perform validation. If validation succeed, then only, so we can able to provide our data. This type of beautiful concept is nothing but what? Data hiding. One of the very important feature for object-oriented programming, even for our certification also. For intra-year room certification, very important terminology. So, how to implement the data hiding? Can you please tell? By declaring variable as private modifier, we can implement the data hiding. Can you please tell what is the main advantage of data hiding? Ayo, respond. What is the main purpose of data hiding? What? If you are going to hide something, wherever hiding is there, the biggest advantage we are going to get is security is the advantage. Are you getting what is the advantage, right? Security. So, my account balance, I can only check, the other people are not allowed to check. My mails, I can able to check, the remaining people can't access my mail database. Clear, right? So, the biggest advantage of data hiding is security. Okay, clear. So what is data hiding? Next, what is the advantage of data hiding? How to implement data hiding? All the things are clear. Outside person should not access our internal data directly. So by declaring data member as the private, we can implement data hiding. The main advantage of data hiding is security. Clear? Sir, in the last video, we covered the first feature, data hiding. Clear, right? So, outside person should not access our data directly. By using private modifier, we can implement data hiding. The biggest advantage is security. Sir, you know, the highly recommended modifier for variable data member is always private. Even in the last videos also somewhere I covered, because to implement data hiding, private must be required. Highly recommended modifier for variables is always what? Private. Okay, well, now the next cinema, what I have to talk, the second WUPO feature, very important, sir, abstraction. Are you getting? What is the concept, sir? Abstraction is the second important WUPO feature, abstraction, like this, right? Sir, take a bit very special care. about this terminology abstraction, right? What the point is, can you please tell what is abstraction? Have you heard anywhere about this one? Forget about programming. In our day-to-day life, abstraction. Have you ever heard about this one? Yes, friends. Abstraction. Okay? Sir, his mind is always abstract. He is not open-minded person. Regarding, he is not open-minded person. Are there, everything is abstraction. They are not going to provide complete information. So something like abstract means not complete. In the last session somewhere we covered abstract class. Have you remember right? Abstract class. Abstract class means partially implemented, not completely provided class. Partial, that is not complete. Such type of word is nothing but abstraction. Okay, well. Sir, in the OOPS, sir, which feature is called abstraction? Very simple, sir. Hiding internal implementation. Hide. Internally, how it is implemented? Hiding internal implementation. Just highlight the set of services what we are offering. Sir, these are the services what I'm going to offer. So I'm going to tell that. But how internally these services are implemented? Sorry, don't ask security reasons. I don't want to highlight my internal implementation. Are you getting? So hiding internal implementation, just highlight the set of services what we are going to offer is the concept of abstraction. Are you getting that? So it's a very important concept. Compulsory while implementing, whoops, we have to take care. Because if I'm going to expose my internal code to any person, then automatically where is the security for our code? That's why. So this feature must be compulsory required. Hide internal implementation, just highlight the set of services what we are going to offer is the concept of abstraction. Sir, best example, sir. I hope everyone in this session, I mean everyone who is seeing this video, used at least once your ATM card, okay, to withdraw money. ATM card at least once you use it, right? Sir, if you go to ATM center, if you swipe the card, then immediately it's going to ask, enter pin number. Yes, I'm going to enter pin number 1234. Once I enter pin number, then immediately, so which operation you want to do? Withdraw operation. Click withdraw button from savings account, 10,000 rupees, enter 10,000, submit. Now, immediately you are going to get 10,000. Yes, like this, we did several times. Now, in this process, I have several doubts are there, sir. What I did is, one fine day, I went to bank. Observe very carefully, sir. I went to the bank near ICICI Bank or HDFC Bank. I went. Once I entered into the bank, on the right hand side, you know, on the right hand side, so there is one customer care or reception or something like will be there. So may I help you? Like, sir, there is one center is there, sir. May I help you? Like, one, sir, cabin by default will be there. Very cute lady is going to sit most of the times, like. Then I went there. Madam, related to my ATM card usage, I have several doubts are there. Can you please help? Like this, I asked this lady. Then immediately, that lady is telling, yes, sir, why not? You can ask your doubts, I can clarify, like. Now the first question I asked that lady, madam, whenever I swipe my card, enter pin number, internally, what thing is happening? Like this I asked her. Then immediately that lady told, sir, your card is valid or not, it is going to check, our software is going to check, like, madam, up to that I know, but my requirement is, internally, which code is executing? Is it Java code or Python code or .NET code? Next, is that a validation, authentication, checking validation, is it happening in the ATM machine or somewhere in the server? If it is happening inside server, okay, where is the location of that server? Again, where is the location, what is the IP address, what is the username and password? Next, which SQL query is triggering? Can you please let me know? Like this I ask her. Are you getting right? Immediately, sir, if you don't mind, Just wait here for few minutes, I will call my next level, that person can guide you like she entered inside. She had a discussion with the manager, those people made a phone call to 100 saying, someone came, he is asking about internally server location, IP address and so on. We thought that is the hacker, can you please come like, they made a call to policeman, within 10 minutes policeman is going to come in front of me. Are you able to get right? So, you are the valid customer of the bank, you have already ATM card, sir, you can able to use this card, but you should not aware internally how that functionality is implemented. Are you getting right? So, if you want to validate, enter, swipe the card, enter PIN number, that's all. Internally validation is going to be happen. Hurry, how the validation is going to be happen? Sorry, bank people, they never going to highlight their internal implementation. Okay, now, if you click withdraw button, if you click withdraw button, sir, I'm taking withdraw button. If you click withdraw button, if you enter 10,000, so you will get 10,000. So internally, how this functionality is implemented, which SQL query is executing, where is the database server is locating, all these things, bank people, they never going to highlight. Are you in the position to understand, right? So this is the, this type of feature, is nothing but abstraction, sir. Bank people through ATM GUI screen are getting they are going to highlight the set of services what they are offering. So ICICI Bank ATM center, they are going to tell, even very recently they got one mini bank ATM machine itself is nothing but mini bank counter, like they got some award. They are going to tell, boss, these are 15 services we are going to offer through ATM machine, like ICICI Bank people are going to tell very proudly. So withdraw facility is there, deposit facility is there, next fund transfer facility is there, so request for checkbook, like there are multiple services you can able to get from ATM machine. But internally, how these services are implemented, at least one service also, they never going to highlight. Are you able to identify? Are you able to understand the point, right? So this concept itself is nothing but abstraction. So in our coding also, compulsory we have to maintain this type of feature. Hide the internal implementation and highlight the set of services what we are going to offer is the concept of abstraction. Is it clear for all of you, right? So by using GUI screens, interface concept, we can able to implement abstraction. Sir, best example, at a programmatic level, just observe this one, sir. Suppose I want to develop a Java application. Assume that it is the Java application, right? Now, there are some services are available, withdraw, funds transfer, deposit, like there are several services are available, right? Now, sir, UI based application, .NET application wants to communicate with this. .NET application wants to communicate with our Java application. So, if you want to call withdraw, just you have to call from your code M1. Okay, in the middle, I will expose all my services through some interface. Sir, M1, M2, M3, M4, something like, it is an interface. Regarding itself is interface. .NET person has to call M1 method. Internally, whenever this person is calling M1, internally, which method is going to execute? Maybe some withdraw method is going to execute. The required result we are going to offer to this .NET person. We never going to highlight internally this application, how it is implemented. Are you able to understand, right? So, because of this abstraction, because of this interface concept, two different applications also can communicate with each other. Yes, can communicate with each other without highlighting our internal implementation. Everyone can able to understand? So abstraction is how much important in our day-to-day coding in real time? Please make sure you should aware. So if the interview person is asking, what is abstraction? Can you please tell what the answer you can able to tell? Yes, friends, what answer you can able to tell? You can tell what answer? okay, hiding internal implementation, just the highlight the set of services what we are offering. Is the concept of abstraction. Okay, clear. By using such GUI screens, interface concept, we can able to implement abstraction. Okay, like. Sir, now what are various advantages of abstraction? So best example for abstraction is ATM GUI screen. Bank people are going to highlight several services, but they never going to highlight internally how these services are implemented. Okay, like. Sir, what advantages are there because of abstraction? Sir, the first advantage, right? Take very special care. What is the first advantage, right? The first advantage is wherever hiding is there, the biggest advantage what we are going to get is security. Are you getting? Wherever hiding is there, the biggest advantage what we are going to get is security. Is the biggest advantage, right? Okay, like. Sir, now the second advantage what we are going to get, the second advantage is, sir, very simple. Outside person don't know about internal implementation. Sir, ATM machine, GUI screen contain some buttons, that's all. We never highlighted internally how these withdraw facility, deposit facility, funds transfer facility implemented. I never going to highlight. So outside person doesn't aware internally how my services is implemented. That's why first thing, security by default we are going to get. First biggest advantage, right? Now second biggest advantage what we are going to get is very, very important points are, take a bit special care. Second biggest advantage what we are going to get is, suppose tomorrow this functionality already implemented by using Java. I thought that Java is not good performance wise. Okay, a new language came, Java language came. I want to replace this Java functionality with Java functionality. Okay, internally I performed that change, but GUI screen is always same. GUI screen is always same, sir. Now end user, whenever he click withdraw, earlier Java functionality is executed, but now onwards it is Java functionality is executed. Now the point is, without affecting end user, we can able to perform any changes in our internal design. Are you getting right? So we can able to change technology itself by maintaining same GUI screen. So either any effect on the end user? No effect. Because end user what is seeing is always the same, but internally how that functionality is implemented, yes, we can able to perform any changes. That's why if you are following abstraction, if you are implementing abstraction, the biggest advantage is, yes, enhancement will become very, very easy. Are you getting? Enhancement will become very, very easy without affecting end user. Happily we can able to perform any type of changes in that. Clear for you? Are you in the position to understand, right? That's all. This is the second important point. Now the third point. Take very, very special care, sir. This is the second. Next, if abstraction is there, if you are not going to highlight your internal implementation to the outside person, okay, maintainability of the application is going to be improved. Maintainability of the application is going to be improved. Modularity of the application is going to be improved, sir. Okay, so compulsory while developing the code, while developing the programming, we should aware abstraction. So security is the one advantage, enhancement is the another advantage, maintainability of the application, modularity of the application is going to be improved. That's all. Getting the basic idea, what is abstraction, what advantages are there, how you can implement abstraction by using interfaces concept, GUI screens, like by using interface GUI screens, by using API, we can able to implement abstraction. Okay, so can you please tell what is the definition of abstraction? If any person is asking, just in one line you have to tell, array hide internal implementation, just highlight the set of services, is the concept of abstraction. What is the biggest advantage of abstraction? Security is the biggest advantage of abstraction. That's all, friends. Sir, in the last videos, we covered about data hiding and abstraction. What is data hiding? Outside person should not access our data directly. By declaring private variable, by declaring variable as a private, we can implement data hiding. What is abstraction? Okay, hiding internal implementation, just highlight the set of services what we are offering. Is the concept of what? Abstraction. Now, the next whoop concept what we have to talk is, yes, take very, very special care, encapsulation. This word is very important for the exam sake, even for interview room also, right? Encapsulation. Are you getting encapsulation? Can you please tell capsule? Sir, what is the meaning of capsule? Can you please tell capsule, sir? Have you ever used the word capsule? If you are feeling cold, then immediately we are going to use cold act capsule. Sir, how the cold act capsule looks like? Do you know? Something like medicine capsule looks like, okay, colorful medicine by default will be there inside. Sir, this is the cold act capsule, one capsule, right? Do you know, whatever medicine required to cure cold act, that medicine is going to be encapsulated. Regarding, is going to be grouped into this capsule. Regarding, capsule is nothing but what? One unit, okay? So all the required things grouped into one capsule is nothing but, this is the medicine capsule, right? Same way, sir, what is capsule yet programming? What is encapsulation yet programming? Very simple, sir. Assume that, suppose student is there. For every student, some data members are there and some behavior methods are there. Something like student name, roll number, marks are data members. Next, get marks, update marks, read, write. These are things are nothing but student behavior. Okay, like the process of encapsulating, grouping data members and the corresponding methods into a single unit. Sir, best example, here I'm taking, for every student, name will be required. Name is required. For every student, age. Next, roll number, marks required. Roll number, marks required. Name, age, roll number, marks are required. Plus, for every student, corresponding methods, okay, read method is there, okay, write method is there, like the corresponding methods. These total data and the methods, I want to group into a single unit. That unit itself is nothing but class student. Regarding student class contain student related data, student related behavior. The process of grouping, combining data members and the corresponding methods or behavior into a single unit, which is nothing but encapsulation. Are you able to understand that? Capsule grouping mechanism itself is like this, right? Sir, every Java class is an example of encapsulation. So from our childhood onwards, in the books, if you open any book, then it's going to tell us what is the meaning of encapsulation. That's all. This itself is nothing but encapsulation. The process of grouping data members and the corresponding methods into a single unit is the concept of encapsulation. Every Java class is an example for encapsulation. Any doubt? Are you able to understand? Theoretically, right? Now, the same concept, a bit more practical orientation, just observe. So in reality, what is encapsulation? Very simple, sir. If any component follows data hiding and abstraction. Sir, last two whoop features whatever we covered. One is data hiding I covered. Second one is what? Abstraction we covered. If any component follows data hiding and abstraction, that component is said to be encapsulated component. Are you getting? If any component follows data hiding and abstraction, that component is said to be encapsulated component. Sir, now observe that I can use the word encapsulation. Encapsulation is equal to data hiding. Encapsulation is equal to data hiding plus abstraction. Data hiding plus abstraction is itself is encapsulation, right? Data hiding plus abstraction itself is what? Encapsulation. So if any component follows data hiding and abstraction, which is nothing but encapsulation. Theoretical, okay, sir. Can you please explain a small chota program to demonstrate this encapsulation, right? Now let me take a small example. I'm taking class account, sir. Observe very carefully. Class account. For every account, private, double, balance. Balance field is there. Private, double, balance. Balance field is there, sir. Now, this balance variable cannot be accessed directly by outside person because the reason is private. Remember this one, because the reason is private. Outside person can't access this data directly. That's why it is the private, okay, data hiding. Next, how the outside person can able to access? Compulsory we have to provide getter and setter methods for this variable, okay? Now I'm taking get balance. Public double get a balance. Public double get a balance. Get balance, balance. Now validate. Sir, perform required validations. Because, so whether this person is the correct person or not, ask his username and password and so on. Yes, valid. If this person is valid, return balance. If this person is the valid, return balance, like this, right? Now, sir, I want to update my balance. Something like public void. Okay, sir, I want to perform withdraw operation. Assume that, sir. Or, sir, I want to change my balance. Set balance, double balance, like this, right? Okay, boss, can you please withdraw so-and-so amount? Or can you please deposit so-and-so amount, like? So here also, you can perform the required validations, okay? If it is a deposit, sir, this dot balance is equal to balance. This dot balance is equal to, sir, this dot balance, balance is equal to, sir, balance, this dot balance plus amount, whatever amount we are going to provide. Sir, assume that amount. So, current balance, plus amount, like this we are going to take. That's all. A simple example, I have balance variable is there. This balance variable declared the private. Outside person should not access our data directly. Next, how the outside person can able to access? Sir, by using getter method and setter method. The advantage of providing access through getter and setter methods is, sir, we can perform the required validations. Are you getting? Outside person is always going to call, either get balance or set balance. So through that, after validation, then only he can able to get the required data or he can able to perform required operations, right? So now I can use the word, it is the best example for encapsulation. Are you getting example for encapsulation? Now I have bigger doubt is there. If you are telling it is the encapsulated component. Compulsory it should follow data hiding and abstraction. Compulsory it should follow data hiding and abstraction. Sir, where is the data hiding? Yes. Yes, where is the data hiding? Declare this variable as a private data hiding. Okay, well, perfect. But where is abstraction? Yes, friends. Where is abstraction? How you can conclude? Yes, sir, this is abstract, abstraction is there in this example. Remember. Remember that. Okay. So, I never going to highlight this get balance, set balance functionality to outside person directly. What I will do? I will, sir, provide, sir, one GUI screen to the end user. GUI screen, maybe JSP based or otherwise some AWT Sphinx based, somewhere, okay, some GUI screen. In that balance inquiry, there is one button, is there, sir? Balance inquiry button. There is another button, is there? Okay, deposit, something like. Whenever end user click balance inquiry, now get a balance method will be executed. Whenever end user click balance inquiry, then get balance method will be executed. Whenever end user click deposit, then set balance method will be executed. Are you getting? Whenever end user click deposit, set balance method will be executed. But end user don't know internally which code is executing, which methods are executing. End user can able to see only these two buttons. Internally, is it Java code, Ratan code, Python code also? You don't know anything about that. Just he is going to click, that's all. The required functionality in the background is going to execute. We never going to highlight our internal implementation to the end user. Are you able to get right? That's why I can use the word. It is, sir, what we call abstraction. So data hiding and abstraction, which is nothing but encapsulation. Everyone can able to understand? Sir, two definitions I provided, right? Sir, what is the definition? One. Grouping data members and the corresponding methods into a single unit is the concept of encapsulation, theoretical thing. If any component follows data hiding and abstraction, that component is said to be encapsulated component. Sir, best example, declare data member as a private, and for every data member provide getter method and a setter method. Okay, like, and we can provide access through some GUI screens. Itself is nothing but, okay, encapsulation, right? Sir, have you observed? Here, one small thing you people should aware, sir. Is it possible to access this data member directly? Can you please confirm? Is it possible to access this data member directly? No, outside person can't access, right? So if outside person want to access, he has to call get balance or set balance method. So through get balance and set balance only, we are going to provide our data. That's why get a balance and set balance. So either interface for outside person, internally our balance data is going to come. That's why hiding data behind methods. Can you please observe my statement very carefully, sir? Hiding data behind methods is the concept of encapsulation. Remember this one, sir. Hiding data behind methods is the concept of encapsulation. Okay, like, now here there are two important conclusions are there. What is the advantage of encapsulation? What advantages are there? Okay, whatever advantages are there for data hiding and abstraction, all those advantages are advantages for encapsulation, because encapsulation is not a new word. It is the data hiding and abstraction only. That's why first one, security, we can able to achieve, or we can able to get security. Second one, enhancement will become very easy without affecting outside person. we can able to perform any type of changes internally, enhancement, okay? Third one, the biggest thing what we are going to get, maintainability of the application, modularity of the application will be improved. Are you getting? Maintainability will be improved, modularity of the application will be improved, sir. This is the advantages for encapsulation. But anyway, among all these things, the main important advantage, whenever we are using data hiding or abstraction or encapsulation, the biggest advantage what we are going to get, security. The first group of OOPS concept is security. Main target is the word security, right? Data hiding or abstraction or encapsulation, security is the important word. Okay, well. Now, there is one more small point is there. If you are getting something, compulsory, universal rule, we have to miss something. Are you getting? If you want to get something, you should miss something. Sir, what we are going to get because of encapsulation? What we are getting because of encapsulation? Security we are getting. But what we are going to miss because of encapsulation? Yes, we have to compromise. We have to sacrifice something, then only we are going to get, sir, the security. What is that? Yes. So, for every data member, compulsory we require to provide getter method, setter method. Every time, validations must be required. Then only I can able to perform required operation. It increases length of the code. Validation, everywhere validation. It increases length of the code, slows down execution. Are you getting? So I want to get balance. So best example, if you want to know your account balance, you are the valid customer. You are valid customer of the bank. But still, you can't get directly your account balance. You have to provide your username, password, then only you are going to get. So validation must be required or not? Yes. If you want something, you should miss something. Here you are going to get security, but it is going to time consuming process, performance is going to be down. Remember that. So that's why, so everywhere, don't try to implement security, don't try to use encapsulation. If a security constraint is there, then only we require to use encapsulation. Sir, best example, I want to perform fund transfer to my friend account, 10,000 rupees. Assume that, sir, 10,000 rupees funds transfer I want to perform in the ICICI bank. To perform funds transfer of 10,000 rupees, how many activities you have to do? You have to provide your username, password. Next and after that, OTP you are going to get. Next, in your card backside grid, you have to enter some numbers. You require to enter some number. After doing all these things, after 3 minutes or 4 minutes, you can able to perform, you can able to complete transaction of 10,000 rupees for your friend. Are you getting? So the problem, time consuming, performance is down. But advantage, right person only can able to perform funds transfer. Security by default you are going to get. Clear? Any doubt about this one? So three words you should aware. What is encapsulation? What is the advantages of encapsulation? What is the disadvantage of encapsulation? These are things you people should aware very clearly, right? Sir, can you please observe the process of grouping data members and the corresponding methods into a single unit is nothing but encapsulation. Next, what we call, if any component follows data hiding and abstraction, is the concept of encapsulation. Hiding data behind the methods is the concept of encapsulation. Advantages, security, enhancement will become easy, maintainability, modularity will be improved. The bigger problems with this is, sir, performance is going to be down because it is the time consuming, length of the code is always going to increase because validation logic is, has to execute. That's all, sir. Clear for all of you, right? Very important this encapsulation word for the exam sake, even for interview room also. A bit theoretical, but compulsory you should aware. Sir, in the last videos we covered data hiding, abstraction, and then encapsulation. It's a very clear. Now, the next thing what I have to discuss, sir, tightly encapsulated class. What is the word? Can you spell out? Tightly encapsulated class. Tightly encapsulated class. Okay. Sir, when we say that a class is said to be tightly encapsulated, are you getting? Sir, usually every Java class is by default considered as encapsulated class only. When we say that it is a tightly encapsulated, if and only if every variable present inside that class is private. Regarding every variable present inside that class is private. Such type of class is said to be tightly encapsulated. Whether the class contain getter methods, setter methods or not, whether these getter methods, setter methods are declared public or not, these things are not required to worry. Only one point we should aware. Every variable present inside that class is a private. Such type of class is said to be tightly encapsulated. 100% data hiding is there, sir. Yes, obviously it is a tightly encapsulated class. Sir, best example, here if I consider public class, class, account. Public class, account, account class is there. Now, I'm taking private double balance variable is there. Now the point is, if I can take public double get a balance, public double get a balance, like this I'm taking a return balance, right? Public double get balance, return balance, like this I'm taking. Can you please confirm, is it a tightly encapsulated class or not? You respond. Is it tightly encapsulated class or not? Yes. Because how many variables are there? Only one variable. That variable is a private or not? Yes, man. It's a private. We never going to worry about this variable, this data member having getter method, setter method or not. Whether these methods are declared as a public or private, we are not required to worry. So, every data member declared as private, such type of class is said to be encapsulated class. Clear for all of you, right? Such type of class is said to be tightly encapsulated class. Okay, well. So now, from the exam, of course, in our OCJA 8 version, this concept is not that much important. But in the old version certification, OCJP 1.4 version, especially in the syllabus, they specified explicitly what is the tightly encapsulated class. Identify tightly encapsulated class like that. That's why just aware. But anyway, for our current certification, this concept is not that much important. Just aware, sir. I have one example is there. Now, observe. Class A, sir. Class A. A class contain private int x is equal to 10, sir. Class A class contain private int x is equal to 10. Class B extends A. Class B extends A. Int y is equal to 20. Class B extends A. Int y is equal to 20. Sir, class C extends A. Private int z is equal to 30. Private int z is equal to 30, like this, right? Can you please tell total how many classes are available? 3. A, B, C. 3 classes are there. Among these 3 classes, which is tightly encapsulated? Which are not tightly encapsulated? Class A tightly encapsulated. Because it contains only one variable and every variable is always private. Of course, only one variable which is the private. That's why tightly encapsulated. Class B is not tightly encapsulated. Because the reason is, class B extends A. Of course, from A, every data member is always private. But here, int y is there, which is not private. Which is not private. Outside person can able to access this data directly within the same package. Any person can able to access this data directly. That's why it is not tightly encapsulated. Because it doesn't contain Every variable at a private, there are some non-private variables are there. Next, what about this one, sir? Class C, extends A, from A, everything is always private. Next in C also, it is always private. That's why by default considered, yes, by default considered, yes, is, sir, is tightly encapsulated. Because, sir, very simple funda, simple rule. Every variable present inside that class, either private, then automatically tightly encapsulated. So A and C are tightly encapsulated, but B is not tightly encapsulated. Okay, well, sir. Now, I'm ready to go for one more example. Even you may get some conclusion also. What is that? Yes. Observe that. Class A, sir. I'm taking class A. Inside class A, okay, just I'm taking int x is equal to 10. Observe very carefully, sir. Int x is equal to 10. Non-private data. Class B extends A. Class B extends A. Private int y is equal to 20. Class B extends A. Private int y is equal to 20. Class C extends B. Class C extends B. Private int z is equal to 30. Like this I'm taking. Private int z is equal to 30. Like this I'm taking, sir. Can you please confirm among these, what is the output by default you are going to get? Please respond. If I can take like this, what the, I mean, which are tightly encapsulated, which are not tightly encapsulated? Can you please tell? Sir, A is not tightly encapsulated because it doesn't contain private, non-private data is there. What about class B? Respond. What about class B? Class B either tightly encapsulated or not? No. The reason for that is class B extends A. Extends A, B is the child class of A. B is the child of A. Automatically, this variable inheriting to the B. Regarding, so this non-private data will come to the B also. That's why it is also not tightly encapsulated. Okay, well. Now, class C extends B. Class C extends B, B. Now the point is, observe carefully. Observe a bit very, very carefully about this one. Class C extends B, private int z is equal to 30. Now, it is the child of B. This non-private data X will come here also. So, it is also contain non-private data X. That's why it is also not tightly encapsulated. So, from this, do you have any conclusion? You can able to conclude very easily. Do you have any conclusion? If the parent class is not tightly encapsulated, then no child class is tightly encapsulated. Remember, because parent class non-private data automatically will come to the child or not? Yes. If the parent class is not tightly encapsulated, then no child class is tightly encapsulated. Remember that? That's why no class is tightly encapsulated. So, the terminology is very clear for you people, right? Not required to keep any explanation. So, what is tightly encapsulated? If each and every variable of a class is contain only each and every variable is the private, such type of class is said to be tightly encapsulated. And sir, whether the class contain getter methods or setter methods, whether those methods are declared as a public or not, all these nonsense we are not required to check. Sir, make sure only one condition, every variable declared as a private or not, that's all. So if the parent is not tightly encapsulated, then no child class is tightly encapsulated. Clear for all of you, right? That's all.